Dear students and viewers, assalamu alaikum. I welcome you all in my YouTube channel, Zed Chemistry. Today we are going to discuss about the effects of electric current or effects of electricity or effects of simply current on different substances by using electric circuit or by using electrolysis process as the indicator. And in this particular topic, we are going to discuss about the process of electrolysis and about the reactions that occurs on the different poles or different electrodes. Let's start with our topic. As we are discussing about chapter chemical effects of current, and in this particular chapter, as I already mentioned you that this electric current is the cause of chemical change, or it causes chemical change in various substances. And if this chemical change occurs at a very fast rate, then we can state that particular substance or that particular material is a good conductor. And if it does not occurs at a faster rate, then the substance is a poor conductor. And to know the nature of the substances, we usually use an indicator there that is called as lead. Or we can state that that's called as light emitting diode. And another is there that is compass. Both these substances, they mention about the extent of current, or they show us about the presence of intensity of current through the conductor. This is the battery, or we can say it is the source of electric current or current. When this current, it moves through this circuit, or it moves through this structure, what happens there? There are two sides, two poles. We can state there are two electrodes. One of the electrode that is anode, and another is that is cathode. One of the electrode that has negative charge, and that has positive charge, while as another has negative charge. And when electric current goes through this, these electrodes are dipped in an electrolytic solution, and the process of electrolysis occurs there. It means that the substance which is present on this these electrodes, they get dissociated. And if any substance is present on it, or any electrolyte is present on it, it simply goes through this solution. We can state that there is the transfer of electric current from this side to this side, or this electric current, it goes from this electrode into this solution, and this particular solution or this particular electrolyte, it breaks into ions. And if the dissociation of the ions occurs at a fast rate, then the electrolyte is a good conductor. Usually the case will maybe with acids or bases, or their salts. Or if the dissociation of the current will not be so much extended, then the substance will usually be a poor conductor. And this good and poor nature of the conductor is known by having a lead or having this compass. What happens in lead? That lead, it is a sort of bulb-like structure. And this lead, we can use simply in the electric circuit, we can simply use bulb side. And this bulb, it glows very much. If the glowing is of much intensity, then the electrolyte is a good conductor. If the glowing is of less extent, then the electrolyte is a poor conductor. Same is the case with this compass. If the deflection, there is the presence of a scale. If the presence of a rather we can say there is a presence of a needle, if the deflection occurs of much extent, then the substance is a good conductor. If it occurs of less extent, then the substance is a poor conductor. This was all about today's topic. Have a nice day.